جميع التكبيرات على تكبيرة الإحرام لأن تكبيرة الإحرام ركن.
So all of the takbirat apart from the first takbirat to ihram which is the rukn, all of the takbirat are from the obligations.
نعم. عندنا من واجبات الصلاة قول قلنا مرة واحدة سبحان ربي العظيم في الركوع.
And also from the wajibat of the prayer we said previously that you have to say at least once سبحان ربي العظيم in the ركوع. At least once.
والزيادة سنة.
And as for saying it more times, then this is recommended.
بما ورد عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And we also say that other remembrances which have been narrated from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قول سمع الله لمن حمدا للإمام والمنفرد.
Also a person saying سمع الله لمن حمدا whether he's the imam or he's praying alone.
قول ربنا ولك الحمد للجميع إمام ومنفرد ومأموم.
And from the obligations is say the saying ربنا ولك الحمد for the imam, for the person praying in congregation behind the imam and the person praying on his own.
قول سبحان ربي الأعلى مرة واحدة في السجود.
Also a person saying سبحان ربي الأعلى at least once as an obligation in the sujood.
والزيادة سنة.
And as for the other remembrances on top of this, and this is sunnah.
بما ورد.
According to that which has been narrated.
قول رب اغفر لي بين السجدتين.
A person saying رب اغفر لي between the two sujood whilst he's sitting.
التشهد الأول.
The first تشهد.
والجلوس له.
And sitting for it.
نعم. يبقى معنا سنن الصلاة ذكرناها في الصفة.
And as for the sunan, the recommended acts of the prayer, then we have mentioned them when we spoke about the description of the prayer.
مبطلات الصلاة.
Those matters which invalidate and break a person's prayer.
ما هي مبطلات الصلاة؟
What are the invalidators of the prayer?
من الذي يعرف مبطلات الصلاة؟
Who knows?
الذي لا يعرف مبطلات الصلاة قد تكون صلاته باطلة وهو لا يدري.
So the person who doesn't know the invalidators of the prayer, those matters which invalidate a person's prayer, perhaps your prayer is invalidated and you don't know. Perhaps you've done one of those things.
العلماء رحمهم الله ألفوا في مبطلات الصلاة. نعم.
The scholars, they authored books all about the things which invalidate a person's prayer.
في نواقض الوضوء.
And also those matters which invalidate a person's wudu, break a person's wudu.
نواقض الإسلام.
And also those matters which invalidate a person's Islam.
المفطرات أو مفسدات الصيام.
And those matters which break a person's fast.
محظورات الإحرام.
And again those things which invalidate a person's Hajj or his Ihram in Hajj.
ما الفائدة؟
What is the purpose behind all of this? What's the benefit?
هل أرادوا بهذا التأليف إبطال الصلاة والصيام والإسلام والحج والصيام؟
So by writing these books regarding these subjects, did the scholars merely want to invalidate people's prayers and soul and hajj and so on and so forth?
لا. أرادوا بهذا أن تجتنب هذه الأشياء حتى لا تكون صلاتك باطلة.
No. What they want from you is that you should avoid these things so your prayer doesn't become invalidated.
إذن ألف العلماء رحمه الله تعالى نواقض الإسلام حتى لا تقع في ناقض. إذا ليس الغرض من التأليف تكفير الناس، لا، الغرض حتى لا نقع في هذا ويكون بهذا الإسلام عليه السلام خروج من الدين.
So the reason why the scholars, for example, spoke about those things which invalidate a person's Islam isn't because they want to call you a kafir and make takfir of you, but to help you stay away from these things and protect your religion.
إذا هذا من النصح للأمة.
So therefore, this is from sincere advice to the Ummah.
إذا الذي لا يعرف مبطلات الصلاة قد تكون صلاته باطلة وهو لا يدري.
So the person who doesn't know those matters which will break or invalidate his prayer, perhaps he has invalidated his prayer and he doesn't know.
والذي لا يعرف نواقض الإسلام قد يكون يخرج بشيء من الإسلام إلى الكفر وكذلك هو لا يدري.
And a person who doesn't know those matters which invalidate his Islam, maybe he'll end up doing something or saying something and he leaves the religion of Islam and he doesn't know.
إذن هذه أمور مهمة لابد أن نتعلم.
So these matters are very important. We have to learn them.
قبل أن نبدأ بمبطلات الصلاة نريد أن نتكلم عن الحركات في الصلاة. أي حركة في الصلاة لابد أن تندرج تحت أنواع خمسة.
Before we speak about those matters which invalidate and break a person's prayer, we want to speak about the types of movements in the prayer. So any movement that a person makes in the prayer, it can be categorized in one of five categories.
حركة محرمة.
Either the movement is haram, it's forbidden.
حركة مكروهة.
Or it is disliked.
حركة مباحة.
Or the movement is permitted and allowed.
حركة مستحبة.
Or the movement is recommended.
حركة واجبة.
Or the movement is an obligation.
الحركة المحرمة مثل.
The actions or the movements which are forbidden in the prayer are like.
الأكل.
Eating.
والشرب.
Drinking.
والضحك.
Laughing.
والالتفات عن القبلة.
And turning away from the قبلة.
والحركة الكثيرة المتوالية عرفا لغير أتركها. نعم. هذه أمثلة على الحركات المحرمة في الصلاة.
So these are examples of movements in the prayer that are not allowed, they are not permitted.
نعم. الحركة المكروهة.
And as for those movements which are disliked.
هي حركة قليلة وليست بكثيرة لكن لغير حاجة.
It is a person doing small amount of movement, so not a lot, but when there isn't a need for him to make that movement.
الالتفات اليسير في الصلاة مكروه. الالتفات الكثير محرم.
So for example, a person turning slightly away from the qibla, this is makruh. This is disliked. And a person turning away from the qibla in totality is haram.
الثالث الحركة المباحة.
As for those movements which are allowed and permitted.
الحركة المباحة التي تكون لحاجة.
Is a permitted type of movement which is done out of necessity.
مثال.
As an example.
يعني وهو يصلي سقط من جيبه شيء من المال مثلا وخاف عليه من السرقة فبأدنى حركة أرجع المال إلى جيبه.
So an example of a movement which is permitted in the prayer is if a person was praying and he went down and let's say some money fell from his pocket and he's scared that maybe somebody is going to steal that money. So with the least amount of movement, he picks up that money and he places back in his pocket.
نعم. الحركة المستحبة.
And then the fourth type of movement is the movement which is recommended.
هي الحركة التي يتوقف عليها كمال الصلاة.
And this is the type of movement that a person has to make in order to perfect his prayer.
مثال سد الفرج.
As an example, closing the gaps.
الخامس الحركة الواجبة.
And then the fifth type of movement is the movement which is an obligation.
وهي الحركة التي يتوقف عليها صحة الصلاة. إن لم يتحرك كانت الصلاة باطلة.
And this is the movement a person has to do in order for the prayer to be complete. And if he doesn't make that movement, then his prayer isn't correct, neither is it complete.
مثال وهو يصلي الآن وجد على غترته أو على الجوربين نجاسة. ماذا يصنع؟
As an example, if somebody is praying and then he realizes that on his socks or his scarf is a najasa, is an impurity, what does he do?
هنا لابد من حركة واجبة. يخلع الغترة أو يخلع الجوربين حتى تكون الصلاة صحيحة.
So here the person has to make a movement. If he wants to keep his prayer complete and intact, then he has to either remove his scarf or remove his socks in order to remove the impurity.
مرة أخرى. حركة واجبة.
So one more time, the movements in the prayer is either an obligation,
كإزالة النجاسة,
like a person removing impurities.
حركة مستحبة.
Or a movement which is recommended,
كسد الفرج,
like closing the gaps, moving to close the gaps.
حركة مباحة.
A movement which is permitted and allowed.
قلنا مثاله لو سقط من جيبه شيء من النقود.
Like as an example, something was to fall out of the pocket and then he picks it up and he puts it back down.
حركة مكروهة حركة يسيرة لغير حاجة.
And a disliked movement, and that is that type of movement which is little, it's not a lot, but there's no necessity for a person to make that movement.
الخامس الحركة المحرمة الضحك والأكل والشرب.
And then the fifth type of movement is the movement which is not allowed, it is forbidden, like eating and drinking, laughing and so on and so forth.